This conference will now be recorded.
I'd like to call a meeting of the Howard Cemetery Commission to order at 9 o'clock, 9:01. Good morning, everybody. You're still muted, Cindy.
Sorry about that.
There you are. Morning, Amy.
Morning.
Now we're good.
Begun for Amy. She leaves on Friday, I believe.
She leaves on Friday? There you go. It's a fun feeling to retire, isn't it?
It's very fun, yeah. It doesn't really feel real yet, but.
Yes, I hope you'll have plenty of time because you'll be busier once you retire than you do when you work.
Yeah.
So Bob's been doing some research on the different funds that we could transfer to, or you've been talking to the bank that, so we should have an idea of what they can do?
Yeah.
Rob, did you want to go, or Amy, you want to tell us what the bank has?
Well, I had sent their, you know, their information to Robin. I don't know if she passed that out or not.
Yeah, I forwarded.
Basically, they would combine your funds, you know, in the portfolio along with the library and a couple other small things that we have, or and a couple other big things that we have, just because you get a better rate when it's all grouped together, but it is still kept separately. So it would be a separate line item on the statement.
But it'll be invested in different funds?
Yeah, I didn't look at the detail of what those were. You know, they have to go by the legal list and everything. So, I didn't have time to look at the actual detail. I don't even know if she sent detail, honestly.
Rob disappeared.
Yeah, where is Rob?
I don't know. He's hiding. What is it in now? Just a regular, like a savings holding type of thing?
Right. Yeah. It's just in a, yep, in a bank account. Yeah. I mean, it was with Century. Technically, it was, you know, a trust account, but not an invested trust account. So, and now Century's been bought out by Eastern, and that's the story there. There it sits. I mean, interest for the past, you know, year or two has not been good. That being said, you didn't lose anything being invested either. So yeah, a lot of the other funds have taken, you know, took a bit of a hit in the past year. But I think it's probably good timing if you wanted to start doing something like this.
Is that like the only thing the bank has to offer is to put in with that other? Just blend our funds and keep it separate?
Well, that would be your best bet as far as fees, because we've already got money with them. So the more they can group together, the lower they can keep your fees.
Okay. Rob, are you there?
You know, the other option would be, you know, just, you know, like a regular traditional CD type of thing or something, which there are some good rates out there now. It's just that's a fixed spot there.
Fixed spot.
Rob just sent me a message. His computer just died.
Oh, he's got to plug it in.
I don't know if he's trying to log it. So, Amy, I had forwarded you some questions that Rob had
sent to Barbara. Yep.
Yeah. Yeah. Sent to Barbara. So, she sent them all to the commissioner, so they all got it.
Okay.
You know, will the funds be part of the town's other trust, i.e. the library? And I think you just answered that.
Yeah.
And then I, you know, of course, I know nothing about bank or investments, so.
Yeah, that's why we hire people to do that.
Back. Yay!
But I got two of them on the screen, though.
Oh, you have two of them? I only have one.
I got another Rob Thompson just sitting there doing nothing.
Oh.
Huh?
Did you miss me? I mean, yeah, I don't know what happened. My computer just died. Went to black screen, Apple symbol, and it's only in 2015. 2019 computer. I'm so sorry. What did I miss?
Nothing. So we're waiting for you.
Oh, well, that's very nice of you. That was a quick restart, too.
There you go.
All right.
Amy was telling us that the bank, we can blend the funds with the library and the and someone else, and then keep all the funds and lower fees and be more of an invested type of an account.
So can I interject here?
Yes.
Yep.
I had a really nice conversation with Barbara yesterday.
Yep.
And she kind of explained the whole process. Sorry, I'm still, stuff is still opening on my computer. So our funds will be kept separate. On that email that Barbara forwarded through Amy and Robin last week, we can invest in any of those legal Massachusetts assets. Our money is kept separate. They can give us a separate report on where it is, how it's doing, et cetera. And the phrase being lumped together with the other town assets or trusts or whatever is just in their accounting that the town through us and the library trust and whomever, their money is in the Rockland Trust system. And because it exceeds a certain amount, the cost structure comes down to the 0.39, 0.36 expense ratio, which, as I said in an email, I mean, it isn't great, but it's, you know, better than a toothache. It's not going to break the bank or anything, you know.
Yeah.
For example, Fidelity's money market account, which is a money market account, they charge 0.42. So the bank, in the light of that, it's a good deal. So then she and I discussed where the money could go and what she meant by Rockland doing they're currently using a balanced portfolio plan. Their version of a balanced portfolio is 65-35, 65% equities, 35% fixed, you know, bonds, money market, cash, whatever. So we can do that any way we want. We can be more conservative, we can be more aggressive. Just depends on what we decide to do. On the equity side, we are limited to those 22 stocks that the state picks. Some of them I kind of scratch my head, but most they all pay a dividend, and they're not bad, but they are just the 22, and that's why I quickly added that page to the Cemetery Commission Google Sheets that I send everybody this morning, just so you can see them there in name and what their symbol is. And then I just for grins, I stuck with the Rockland plan of a 65-35, and then I pulled 5% off of the equities, 5% off of the bonds to create a money market account, which you could subtitle as the Robin Kelly War Chest.
No, not Robin Kelly anything.
meaning that the next tornado that comes through and you have to do a project like that, there's your money. Mm-hmm. So I specifically asked Barbara, so when we get paid dividends and interest from the stocks and the bonds in this perpetual care fund, where does it go? They usually use 1% in the money market, but I kind of like the idea of the Robin War Chest, where the money's there. We don't have to sell anything. I mean, as you know, right now with the stock market down, selling assets is not a smart thing to do.
Right.
If the dividends and interest came in and were deposited in that money market account, you know, we would fund it right now at 10% or whatever number we choose, and it would slowly, you know, increase, and then they periodically would rebalance. I didn't think to ask her, do they do quarterly or annually? It doesn't matter. So yes, eventually that the war chest, the money market account, would get to 18%. They would rebalance, meaning they would take the excess of that 10% and then just redistribute it. They buy more shares of the equities, they put more into the bond fund, whatever. And then the email that I sent her this morning, I was very curious about the trust, the treasury aspect, because, you know, treasuries are a confusing animal, and I don't want to, you know, overstep. If you already understand this, that's fine. I mean, I've been doing this for years, and treasuries, I still scratch my head. So you want to be in treasuries because in a normal stock market, when stocks go down, treasury values go up, and when stocks do this, which is what you want to make money, bonds do this.
Yep.
So they preserve value. So you could make the argument that a perpetual care fund, you would want all bonds. But if I had the time and I knew how to do it with Caleb, I put up a chart that goes, yeah, if you were all in bonds right now, the last couple of years, you would have lost your shirt.
Yep.
So you don't want to do that either, which is why I kind of like using Rockland's recommendation of 65-35 or 60 or whatever. But I asked her how they break up the fixed income aspect, because there's ETFs, mutual funds we're allowed to use, but she also said they can do bond ladders. And their recommendation, this is from her email, depending on the asset allocation chosen by the commission, I'm reading her email, we would diversify the account using all securities available within the constraints of the mass legal list. For their fixed income allocation, we use individual treasury, agency bonds are like your mortgage-backed securities, things like that, and allowable corporate bonds. So all of those corporate bonds from assuming investment grade companies would pay a dividend interest as well. From the allowable ETFs, they use TIPS, mortgage-backed. TIPS are treasury inflation bonds, which are very good to fight inflation, mortgage-backed securities, and add additional diversification to other asset classes within the fixed allocation. So in a nutshell, that what that boils down to is they build a diversified fixed income side, which now you're getting your money for your 0.36
yep.
investment expense. You're paying them to be smarter than we can all be. I mean, unless we've all got degrees in finance, and those are the people I rarely trust anyway, because they want to make... So they're not trying to get rich on us, and I was very comfortable talking to her.
Okay. So that's 60-40 fund or 65-35 fund, that sounds pretty good then?
Well,
how do we set up an account where the interest goes into that we can pull from?
Yeah, so let's look at that ratio. Right now, because even though the Fed is raising interest rates, and yes, you could go buy a 2-year treasury note or 5-year treasury bill and get, you know, 4% interest, what happens to the value of that treasury bond kind of depends on what the Fed does the rest of the year, next year, because if they reach their inflation level, they're going to bring rates back to 2%. Which means that those treasuries will be worth more, because people will go, oh yeah, I want that, because it pays 4%, when we go right back to the low interest rates, which is why you couldn't make any money in treasuries. Now, if inflation kind of stays up, the only way to beat inflation is to be in treasury protected bonds, TIPS, or to be in stocks. Now, stocks carry their own risk, except if the state, the Massachusetts chosen stocks should have what they call a low beta. I didn't look at that number, which means that they don't do this, they do this.
Yeah.
You know, they don't move, they're counter-cyclical. They don't move in step with the stock market. You always, especially
retirees,
you want to be lower than that. So getting back to, should we do 65-35? I mean, we could, your traditional balance fund, if you bought the Fidelity balance, the Vanguard balance, they're usually 50-50. That's why they're called balanced, 50% bonds, 50% stocks. I looked up the Vanguard balanced Admiral the other day, and it was 70-30, because they recognize what's happening with bonds. So, you know, that's good intelligence to, I think, to see what other investment funds are. So based on that, I would personally not want to go lower than 50-50, perpetual care fund or not. And we can certainly adjust that.
Yeah. Does a Rockland offer that 50-50 on that?
No, they're 65-30.
Oh, that's the only one they got?
No, it's not that. It's not the only one they have. It's if we were to call Barbara or Amy says, okay, Barbara, here's the money, it's coming from wherever, and the commission voted on 65-35, and actually, well, getting back to the war chest, I would go 60-30-10. That would be me. The 10% is that cash reserve fund. It's still fixed income because it's invested in a treasury money market, I believe. So it's very, very safe. And then that's the available cash if something happens and Robin needs to go do something, or, you know, we find a need and it would be better to use perpetual care money than drain down the revolving account or what have you.
Now, the principal balance in that account, do we know?
I'm sorry.
Do we know
right now it's about 446,000, just a little bit over that.
And how much of that was the interest that we could spend out of that now if we had to?
Oh God.
We don't know that.
Amy, didn't you say it's all in a savings account?
Right now, yes. Well, it's in a money market account.
So it's all available.
Right.
I mean, you could write it.
But I don't know what your starting point is on that. I don't know how much of that you can't spend.
Right.
That's what I was asking. I didn't know what the original principal amount is in there that we can't touch. Because we can only spend the interest.
Well, the principal you could invest.
See furious computer typing.
Yeah, I don't even know what the starting point was on that account.
We should have that number somewhere, I would think.
So I think every time I post into that and from the original balance that I had, I have 450,480.
Okay.
So the difference.
She hasn't. Emery hasn't had me do any transfers for that since June. Okay. So we're behind on those.
All right.
As far as you know, what should be posted to that account in the bank? I mean, I'm sure the general ledger is correct. It's the bank. She hasn't had me make those transfers yet.
Okay.
So, all right, so this is a new twist to this. So if we were to take entire perpetual care, transfer it, Amy, I think you said it was at Eastern Bank?
Yes.
So all of that money that's in that account goes to Rockland.
Yeah.
And Steve, you said we're only allowed to spend the interest.
Yeah, that's all we can spend, isn't it, Robin?
Yep.
Okay, so now we are resetting the account. If we did, if just for grins, if we did 60-30-10, is that allowable for that 10% to be available to you? Because that would be $45,000, which is a lot.
Do we touch that, Robin, or we have to?
No, I don't think we can, because remember, Amy, when we went through and we took out the $30,000 that we had accumulated for interest for the tree thing?
Mm-hmm.
For the tree? That was almost all of our expendable interest at that point.
Yeah.
So that was 2 years ago. So it would be the interest that we've received since that that transfer.
Right, which hasn't been much.
Right.
Yeah.
That's why we're trying to fix it. So,
yeah.
So we need it to grow.
60-40 or something like that, then have a little account that the interest the interest or whatever dividends they pay into it goes into that other account that we can use, because that'll all be interest, so to say.
Well, there's probably a way. All right, so if we, I imagine we'd have to call Barbara real quick before we did all this, but we're going to need to know what the available interest number is. And then that would go into the money market account.
Yep.
Then everything else would be invested roughly, let's say we vote, we haven't voted yet, but let's say 60-30. With the goal of the money market getting to 10%, I imagine that there's a way for Barbara to build that in the documentation, so that as the dividend, because those dividends are going to get paid quarterly,
yep,
and the interest is going to get paid depending on what she's in, either monthly or semi-annually, the way treasuries work, and the corporate bonds I think are quarterly. That money would then, we could instruct her to fill up the money market account. And then at that point, when they do a rebalance, it rebalances to 60, 30, 10 or whatever.
Yeah.
Now, is so
I have a question. So yeah. Amy, when we deposit into, like I make my weekly deposits or whatever, and I'm putting money into the perpetual care account, mm-hmm, when does it get transferred out of your care and custody and into whatever this investment thing is?
Into, so you said, well, I mean, you know, Carol and I were pretty much doing that monthly.
Right.
Emery did it for the end of the fiscal year when she first got here, but it has not been done since. So there's a whole half a year's worth of stuff to move in there.
Okay. So where is it sitting now? It's just sitting in.
She needs to give me the number that I need to transfer into your bank account.
Oh, okay.
All yeah. Right. I mean, it's just in a regular bank account right now. So it's not like it's losing any. It's just not making, I mean, she'll have to allocate interest too, I guess, because it's been so long. Right. I mean, when Carol and I were doing it monthly, it was kind of, you know, it was all right. But now that it's been 6 months, she's probably going to have to allocate, you know, a certain amount of interest to that transfer also. You know what I mean?
It just could go in the money market account.
Right.
Well, so maybe we need to back up one step and pick an asset allocation. Cynthia, you're awful quiet. Taking it all in.
Taking it all in. Now, Rock only does that 65-35 or 60-40. Does Rockland do any other, like, more balance instead of 65-35, go up like 60-40?
Yeah, her email said you could do whatever you want.
And that's what she told me on the phone call yesterday. She said, if you want to be more aggressive and do 70% stocks, 30% bonds, you could.
Mm-hmm.
Wanted to be super conservative and do 30% stocks and 70% bonds, you could. I just stuck with the, just for the sake of conversation, what they are using in their definition of balanced, which is 65-35.
I'd be more comfortable probably going like 60-40 and then, hey, taking whatever interest in opening up a money market so we have access to that.
Well, that would get opened at the same time. That would all be part of it, because your money market is part of your fixed.
Yep.
It's cash. It's just the lowest paying.
But I don't think we're going to have that number anytime soon. Is that correct, Amy?
You'd have to check with Amory. I don't know where she is on that stuff. Yeah.
Amy's leaving on Friday. And can we revisit it and update it once she gives us the.
Yeah, if we set it up, we can talk to whoever at that point and they can rebalance it or move things around to change the allocations at that point.
Well, I mean, you're picking your allocation. You're the big picture of 60-40, 65-35, 50-50, that is just a general term in conversations. Mm-hmm. I only like American League Baseball. It's all it is. It's just a generalization. Because the money market is actually part of the fixed.
Yeah.
So as it gets fine-tuned, you would just set that up that way. But I think if we just pick a number, you want 60-40, 60-40 is fine. I mean, I would actually work backwards and go, Robin, how much do you want to have available? Earth to Robin.
We haven't been using that money. We've been using the cemetery revolving for right now. So the only time I've had any expenditure taken out of that is when we did the tree article at town meeting floor. Rather it grow for a actual.
It's still going to grow.
Right.
It's how much do you want to have growing less? How much would you like to have available? So the tornadoes were what, $30,000?
Just for trees. I mean, we actually got federal funding to pay for the damage that was. We were lucky enough to get that. It could have been catastrophic, though.
And before that, how much had you used from perpetual care?
The only other time we used perpetual care was when we developed the Evergreen Cemetery. Okay. We paid for the infrastructure for that. So the roadways, the water, the engineering and everything, the whole layout of the newer Evergreen section. So I've been here in 2019, we have, 2008, we really haven't used perpetual care all that much because you only can expend the interest.
All right. So Rockland normally rebalances to 1%, which would be $4,500. Okay. And you, since we don't know how much interest is there right now available, okay, we could start the ball rolling. Steve recommends 60-40. We'll have a vote on this here in a second, I guess. And then we say, Amy, move it. And we inform Barbara to do 60-40 or whatever the number is, okay? And and then we can tell her, do we have a ballpark of what this interest number is? Just a wild guess.
What Rockland would make on that?
Oh, the interest right now that we're allowed to spend. That's what I mean.
I have no idea.
This is not an official number. This is just throw the dart.
Because see, I don't know what your starting point was. So it's hard to say. You know, I mean, I can tell you what you earned last year or this year to date or whatever, but I don't know what the starting point on that trust was. So, I mean, out of that $446,000, Robin thinks that we used most of the interest when you did the tree thing.
All right. So, right? How much did we earn this year? I almost don't want to hear this. But
I mean, for this fiscal year to date, you got $35. Last year, all for the full fiscal year, it was $221. It hasn't been good.
Right. That's why we're here now.
Right. Exactly.
Okay. All right. So in that case, then pick our allocation number, get the money moved, and then we'll have to have a conversation with Barbara that says, invest whatever the number is, 60-40, invest that appropriately with she's still going to take at least 1% and stick it in the money market.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So if we tell, 5% is $22,500. To me, that would be a comfortable war chest. Mm-hmm. And then in keeping with the laws or rules of perpetual care that you can only spend your interest, if we know that number, then we can track, because Rockland's going to send us statements, we can track the growth with the dividends and interest.
Mm-hmm.
And then once, let's say we put 5%, 22.5 in the money market. When we get 22, when we double that, so it would be $45,000. Now you know, Robin, that you have 22.5. And then when they rebalance, they're going to take that original 22.5 out to rebalance it and leave you with 5%, 22.5. And now after that, excuse the phrase, money laundering operation, the money in the money market is yours to spend, ours to spend, if necessary. And since you only do this every couple of years, we have time to make that all work out.
Right.
Because we're going to, if it's 450 times 0.035, I'm going to be generous. We're going to make $15,750 in dividends and interest, conservatively, over the next each year. So in 2 years, you're going to have $31,000 in there. So this would all reset and within 2 years, you'll be back to normal. Or the money market account, you will know and can use that alone as you're tracking for available spending cash.
Right. So the other thing is the other accounts will be earning interest as well.
What other account?
So when we do the 60-40, we'll be getting money from that too, right? Is it?
Okay. This is where I wish I had a big board to write this out. So 60-40. So of those 22 stocks that I sent you on that spreadsheet, 60% of the money, 200 and whatever that number was, 60,000.
We'll be divided up into that.
Will be equally divided between those corporations. Yeah. Some will go up, some will go down, but that's the total value. However, quarterly, and they all pay in different quarters, quarterly, hopefully, knock on wood, they will be paying a dividend. Some pay over 3%, some pay less than 3%. Yep. Okay, I didn't have time this morning to calculate it. I will, you know I will, and I'll send it to you, but I can tell you exactly how much they're gonna pay us in the next year. That's in dividends. Then the 40%, that's gonna be broadly invested in treasuries, investment grade corporate bonds, mortgage-backed securities, they use the whole thing. That's what she told me in that email. And that is probably going to pay 3 to 5%. I mean, a two-year treasury note, if you went to your broker and said, I'd like to buy a two-year treasury note, it's going to pay you 4.3%, according to this morning on CNBC. 4.3% to tie up your money for 2 years, guaranteed you get your money back. Because it's a treasury note. Now, the only problem with that is inflation is what? 5.9%? Technically losing money, which is why you really don't want to be overly invested in treasuries and bonds because they don't keep up. But if the market goes and crashes, then you're going to lose 60%. And this is the way we are living our retirement. The stocks go up and down. If the dividend payers keep paying a dividend, as I joke around here, oh, look, another dividend. That money keeps coming unless they stop paying a dividend. But all of those companies, except General Electric, that was one of the ones I was scratching my head at, that the state invests there. They must be in the state somewhere as an industry. They slashed their dividend in 2009. So that's why I'm not a fan of investing in GE. But anyway, so to answer your question, Robin, the long way, that 60% of stocks, when they pay a dividend, it's going in the money market. Okay. When quarterly, semi-annually, when the bond side of it pays interest, it's going into the money market. And that's why I say that would be about $15,750 a year, give or take. And once I see what she put the money in, I can tell you exactly in about an hour what it'll be, because I'll load it in my thing.
Okay.
So Cindy, you're awful quiet. What do you think about, but you guys are retired, so what do you think about a ratio?
I think the 60-40 is good.
Okay.
Yeah. I think this
60/40.
Yeah, I'm gonna be too heavy in stocks because if something happens, then we're sitting here with nothing in the perpetual care.
Right. I mean, the same could happen with bonds if you went 50/50, but
yeah.
But you're guaranteed to get that money back. So if you bought a 10-year bond for $10,000 in our fund, yeah, the bond may be worth less. So that snapshot every month, it would go, oh, we lost money, we lost money, we lost money. But at the end of the 10 years, the government's going to hand you your $10,000 back. But you got to wait 10 years to get it.
Yeah.
So, yeah, I mean, I can go either way. I mean, I could go super conservative because it is perpetual care.
We could always turn it down to more secure stuff or safer later on down the road. We just got to get some, let it make some money first.
I get the feeling it's a phone call to Rockland and say, we want to change our
allocations.
Amy, can you?
Yeah.
I mean, if let's say things got, let's pick a catastrophic thing.
Yeah.
We get involved in Ukraine, boots on the ground. Uh-oh, the market's not going to like that. Hey, forget it. We'd rather be more conservative. Make us 40/60. That's a phone call to Barbara and yeah. So
yep.
You may lose a little in the process. That's the only scary thing about this. But I really think since Robin rarely uses this, and I think at the last meeting at the community center, you said you can't foresee using this money.
I can foresee using it for certain things, but not, you know, right now we're sitting pretty good, but you never know. I mean, people could stop buying cemetery lots. We could, you know, stop doing burials, but that's when it's really comes into play, when the cemeteries have all been built out
and filled up.
Yeah. Some towns don't even have burials anymore, which is crazy, but I believe I'm getting more and more every year, but, so I think eventually it's going to be needed, but right now I think we're sitting in good shape, but we really want the money to create some type of interest because right now it's getting none. So not responsible to get in.
Yeah.
So if you go 60/40 and haven't put 10% in the money market, like you suggested?
Well, actually looking at those numbers and based on what Robin said, I would maybe go 5%.
5%?
Yeah. So I would. So that's where, yeah. So
60/35/40,
which is really, if you want 60% in stocks, and that's really 60/35/5 in the big picture.
Mm-hmm.
But, and I mean, I guess Robin, you don't really get to vote on this, but based on what you just said, would you be more comfortable being more conservative? I mean, we don't need
this.
At
this point, I think at this point, yes. But I mean, we could always revisit it if we ever have issues and then we can revote. But I kind of want to do
kind of towards like 50/50.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, we can wind up at 50/50. If we go 60/40 now, then you got a little bit extra growth to build up that. The usable fund.
Okay.
That was my thought.
Cindy?
I think you guys are right on it, I think. You guys are a lot more intelligent than I am and more up on stocks and things. But that 65/35/5 sounds good.
So a 60/40, yeah. Okay.
Yeah.
So Steve, no, I'll make a motion. So I make a motion that we instruct Amy through Barbara or vice versa to transfer the money as soon as possible from Eastern Bank to the Rockland Trust to set up the Harwich Cemetery Perpetual Care and instruct Rockland Trust to invest it in 60% of the available 60% of that money in the allowable stocks and 35% into a fixed income portfolio and 5% in a money market.
But then we'll rebalance it once that 5% has been met by interest.
Right, and all dividends and interest deposited in the money market account and then rebalance.
That way we know how much we have and the principal just stays there.
Well, we can track it and they'll track it. As soon as we get our first statement from them, we'll just, I'll put it on that spreadsheet and it'll be there in Google for everybody to see.
That's great.
Do we need a second?
I have a second on that motion?
Yeah, I'll second it.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Cool.
Thank you for all your work on it, Rob and Amy. I appreciate it, believe me.
Yeah.
What's that?
It says he fills up the email box. Okay, do you have any other questions, Amy?
No, Robin, if you want to just send me an email just so I have something to, you know, go by, and I will email Barbara off this afternoon. Because, I mean, the money, it's the money's the money. It doesn't necessarily have to come from Eastern. I have money that sits in another account in Rockland, so I can get that open today, really. Well, as soon as they can do it.
Right.
Feasibly. So, yeah.
That's good. Yeah, and then maybe some forensic accounting to figure out what the available interest is, you know, since the tornado withdrawal, I guess.
Yeah.
Just so Robin has a number, you know, and then we can use that as the baseline to start figuring out what is allowed to be spent, you know. Mm-hmm. So does that close that item out, boss?
I think so. Yep, I think we're good.
Hey, Robin, so I got a new business. What's going on with minutes?
I haven't had a chance to do any of the minutes. I'm actually working on the end of the year report, which is due next week.
it was a loaded question because of the holidays. It just dawned on me. Minutes come flashing. Talking about a clogged inbox.
I have a ton of reports that have to get finished, and I still have to do the GPR work out at that cemetery in the West Baptist Cemetery. So
I'm going to make Steve cringe. Boy, we really need an assistant. Bob, at the moment.
Been down there already.
I couldn't resist. Cindy's laughing over here.
So do I have a motion day? Is there any other business? Questions?
We have a meeting next Tuesday.
Next Tuesday, we can address all this. Hey, Amy, when are you done?
Friday.
Well, congratulations and enjoy retirement and go have some fun.
I will. Thank you.
Good luck to you. You will be missed for sure.
Thanks.
Any word on the replacement yet? Are they?
No, they've got Bob Lawton coming in a couple days a week, I think, mostly to do banking, but that's as far as I've heard.
Joe better sharpen his pencil. He's going to have to do it. Not in his job description, I don't think.
I don't know about that.
Do you have a motion to end the meeting?
So moved.
Yep.
Okay, the meeting's done at 9:44.